Okay, now that I've made the changes in the configuration for the Biorhythm program, I'm going to start it again, and it should take me right directly into the graph view of the Biorhythm software. And here we go. It shows me the little Captain Biorhythm status down here at the bottom, and that's a good thing. It shows me my little happy face that's red that shows that I'm having a tough time today, but I will not give up. I'm going to continue on. And so when you look at the Biorhythm chart here, I have it set as Captain Biorhythm. He's my default character for this particular thing. I'm going to go ahead and explain what actually is happening here in this view. If you look at this line, this is the center line right here, and this is the crossover critical line. This is where most people are unstable, have accidents and injuries, make mistakes, get sick, and die. And that's from the research of Dr. Fleisch and Dr. Swoboda, who kept track of people, their patients that were sick, so when they got sick and when they died. So Biorhythms, if you see that you have major difficulties on the crossover days along the center line, that means that you've got some type of pathology going in your system. Either your hormones are out of balance, or your body's out of balance biochemically, or you just don't have the correct mental thought processes. All the different doctors, like Dr. Tatai, who's an MD in Japan, he found that a lot of biorhythms instabilities were caused by imbalances in the hormone system. So let me go ahead and explain what we have here. This is our center line. So at birth, you start at zero, and then all the cycles go up at the same time. This is the intellectual cycle. I have it listed as green, and when you go over the little node, it turns yellow, and it tells you what's going on. This is called a subcritical day. It's when the biorhythms peak out. That's where you have your maximum amount of energy, but again, it's peaking, and then it's going to shift, and it's going to start going back down again. So in all the cycles, they go up and they peak. This is the emotional cycle. And then they start going down again. And then they cross over the line. And because this unique software gives you the ability to put in your birth time, it can actually tell you when you're going to cross over. So it's not exactly on the line. It's somewhere within the 4 hours of your birth time that usually you'll cross over. Like I was born at 6:34 p.m., so anywhere between 4:34 p.m. and 8:34 p.m., that's when I usually cross over. So I know that I'm going to be most unstable at that time during the day. So it's a great thing if you can know at what time of day you were born. And so when you go down here, this is called another subcritical day. This is when the energy bottoms out and starts going back up. Most people are most unstable when the energy is crossing over the center line, because that was established the day you were born. It's probably the most critical day of your entire life, because you either lived or died at that moment in time, and your body had to take over from your mom and just start working on its own. So it was a very critical day. And so usually all the cycles will go up. They'll peak, they'll cross back over, and then they'll go down again and bottom out. So these cycles go on for an entire life, and they only repeat themselves a little bit after 58 years old, the same values that you had when you were born. So I'm thankful I passed through that. I'm 60 now, so I feel good about that. And so it's invaluable information. And down here at the bottom, you can see what the date is. Like today is 6/10, not June 10th. So you can actually see what your biorhythms are. And it can actually tell you how many days you have, and it gives you good information on what you can do for that particular value at that particular time. It gives you good information in the little windows that pull open, and I found that invaluable. It tells you what cycle you're on. I use the little symbols of the rain clouds. I think those are particularly good for helping me understand what's going on. So you have the peaks, which are critical days, subcritical days. You have the crossovers, which are major critical days when most people really screw up. And then you have the subcritical days down here. And so the values here, if you actually looked at this point in time, it would be minus 100 value. That's where you're totally bottoming out. Because the way that it works is that the minus 100 is at the bottom, and the plus 100 is at the very top. And so you start at zero, go all the way up to 100, then you go down to zero again, and then you go all the way down to a minus 100, and then you follow that pattern. It's the same with each of the biorhythms. If you go for the physical, here's a 99.9. You go back down here, we don't have any crossing over the center line, so it would be zero. Since this is below the line, it would be a minus. And so that gives you good information on what's going on. Now when you look over here, we're looking at this in the graph view, and by choice, I have chosen just the physical, and that gives you a little understanding of what the physical cycle is. Then I have the emotional, and then I have the intellectual. These are the historic biorhythm cycles, and these are the ones that I follow most of the time. But this program is so powerful, it gives you the ability to look at your secondary rhythms, where the mastery is a combination of the classical biorhythms, the passion, and also for the wisdom. And with these, you can basically see what the impact of combining the physical, the emotional, and intellectual for different situations is. And for those that are into oriental type medicine, you can actually see what the I Ching cycles are all about. And it's interesting to check these and just see what the story is, because, you know, it's amazing which cycles affect you the most. Most people don't even know about these cycles. And so there's a spiritual cycle in the intuitive patterns, there's a psychic cycle and a success cycle. Down here we have the custom based cycles, where if you just click on that, that would be the primary for the I Ching. Well, actually, the primary would be the primary biorhythms, and then you have the I Ching here. And so it just gives you an idea of what's going on. And you can turn off the groups of the biorhythm cycles at one click. Like if you want to turn off the primary cycles, you click this little icon here. If you want to turn it off, you click it. Okay. Now if you want to turn on the secondary, here are the secondary cycles, you click that and that turns them on. You click it and it turns them off. And then we have the I Ching cycles right here. This does them all at one time. You click it, turns them all off at one time. And then this is for the intuitive patterns. You click that and it automatically puts the little check marks in the boxes in the intuitive, and you click it and it takes it off. Now down here, this is set the color. You can actually set the colors of the different cycles. Each one, you can have your own particular color that you really love. You just click in the box and it will tell you what choices you want. You can click on here to get a lot more colors, or you can actually define the colors and get a color scale. So that's more of an advanced application, but you can totally customize this program according to what your perspective is on the colors that represent each of these different things: success, psychic, perception, spiritual, awareness, aesthetic, wisdom, passion, mastery, intuitive, intellectual, emotional, and physical. I like the red for the physical, the blue for the emotional, and the green for the intellectual. But these are really neat because you can do it in groups and instantly see how those things are impacting you, especially on days that are very, very unique. It gives you the ability to just see amazing things. And so I'm going to turn these guys off. And you always have to have one cycle turned on, so it doesn't matter which one it is. Most of the times, like if I had the physical cycle, that would be the one that would show up. So it's important to remember that you actually can do that. And so you got to have one cycle, so that's the one that you do. And so that's pretty much the graph, and you can actually save the graph as far as the graph readings for individuals, and you can even print them out. So I'm going to go back and just check my favorite cycles, the physical, the emotional, and the intellectual, and then I'm going to click on this and I can actually save it. I can actually save it and say Captain Biorhythm for June 2009, okay? And then it'll let me save it someplace wherever I want. And usually when I'm saving stuff, I'll just save it to the desktop because that's easier to find. And so it tells me what it is. It's going to change, save it in the JPEG format, which is a compressed version, but you can do it in a PNG, which has a lot more information in it. The GIF, the graphics interchange format, that's more condensed. It's not as easy to change it. So your best ones for changing stuff are JPEG. That's one of the most compressed. And if you really want to do some type of graphical changes on the photo, then that would be the good one. We're going to just save it as the JPEG, and we just click on save. And so I just saved that particular view of the Captain Biorhythm chart. Now, if I wanted to print that out, I could go here and print on the print preview, and it would give me a view of what's going on in the printing of the biorhythm chart. Now here, if I click on this, it's going to show me what it will look like when I actually go ahead and print it out.